Hey guys, this is Modelman and welcome to another episode of Modelman Animation. In my FAQ playlist, I answer the questions that you ask in the comment section of my tutorials. Today we're gonna answer this question. Here I have an animation of Deadpool fighting a fly in a desert. Let me play it for you. Now I wanna show you the layers of this project. We have foreground, some stones, Deadpool, the shadow of Deadpool on the ground, and the background that covers all over the screen. Okay, let me turn off this option and go back to frame zero. As you can see, the colors of our character don't match with the desert, and the reason is they're too saturated. Saturation simply means the intensity of the colors. So if you're increasing the saturation of the colors, you're increasing the intensity of them. In this case, we want to change the saturation of Deadpool only, but Moho can't change the saturation of a layer. We don't have such an effect in Moho. On the other hand, software such as Adobe After Effects have this feature. That's why we want to send this project to Adobe After Effects so we can apply the saturation effect. In Moho, to render your frames transparent, one way is to render it using this preset, MOVPNG Alpha PCM, which is the best way because this way you can keep the quality of the video and the sounds and render your layers with less size than the second way. And the second way is, you can use PNG sequence format to render. You might say, after all, it's just a series of PNG images. So how am I supposed to convert them into a video? And the answer is you don't have to. Let me explain this to you. We have a format called PNG, which is a single image, but this one that Moho has is not PNG. It exports your entire project frame by frame as a series of PNG images. So that's why we call it PNG sequence format. And the thing is, Adobe After Effects doesn't have to convert them into a video. You simply can import your PNG sequence as one single layer, just like a video layer, into your Adobe After Effects project. So based on this explanation, now you know that exporting these layers as PNG sequence should do the trick. Of course, if you're more comfortable with MOV, there should be no problem with using it. In case you're wondering how we can do the same thing in Adobe After Effects, before you render, you simply set this option to RGB plus alpha and render your project without any background. It's worth mentioning that Adobe softwares don't support AVI PNG alpha PCM and ASF PNG alpha PCM. Also, if you render your project with MOV ProRes alpha ALLC, your render won't be transparent. Now that we know rendering different parts of a project gives us the ability to apply some effects on them separately, we know that we should separate this project before we render it. How you separate it is completely up to you. For example, in my project, I want to separate it into three parts: the foreground, Deadpool, and the background. So to render the foreground, I'm gonna keep the foreground and turn off the rest of them. Let's keep these tones as well. Okay, this should be our foreground. To render, you can hit Ctrl E or go to File and choose Export Animation. After you open it, you go here and choose Image Sequence and make sure your preset is PNG. The other way was to choose the video format and choose MOV PNG Alpha PCM preset. And then you can go here to save your file. There is an option called Choose Folder, and you see some addresses below it. These addresses are the ones that you've used recently. Since I want to use one of these addresses, I select it. But if you want to choose a new address, you can click on Choose Folder. Now that you told the Moho where to save, you can write the name of your file here and then click on OK to render. Choosing PNG or MOV doesn't make your rendering process faster. Next, I'm gonna render all of the layers except Deadpool to render it separately. And since I don't want to render the background, again, when I choose Export Animation, I have to choose PNG sequence or the MOV PNG Alpha PCM preset and render. Since this character has a lot of layers, it will take more time to render. Okay, now I'm gonna turn it off and turn on the background layers, the shadow on the ground and the desert. And as you can see, they cover all over the screen. So I can just leave this option as it is and render it in video format because we don't need it to be transparent. And after choosing the address, I just click on OK to render. It's time to open Adobe After Effects and import our rendered files into a new project. To start, I'm gonna double click on here and then go to address of your file and then double click on it to import it. To import PNG sequence, select one of the images and then hit Ctrl A to select all of the images. And don't forget to check this option, PNG sequence, to import it as one layer. I'm gonna repeat the same thing to import my foreground as one layer. And now all of the files are ready. Before we continue, I want to tell you something. When you try to import MOV PNG Alpha PCM video into your Adobe After Effects project, there is a window called Interpret Footage that pops up, and it has some options. Using Ignore, you can import your project with the background color, so there won't be any transparency. Then we have Straight, that imports your transparent video, and if you check Invert, it will remove the character instead of your background. And then we have pre-multiplied. If I want to explain it for you, every photo is actually a series of pixels. Every pixel can be filled with a color with no transparency, or it can be partly transparent or completely transparent. Pre-multiplied tries to mix a certain color with all of your partly transparent pixels. You might think this project only has pixels with no transparency and pixels that are completely transparent. But every time you render a transparent video with MOV PNG Alpha PCM, Moho actually adds a series of partly transparent pixels around all of the objects of your project. Therefore, choosing pre-multiplied will mix a certain color with all of your pixels and bring lots of annoying pixels around your objects. The default color of that certain color is black. If you want to change it, you click on it. Or if you want the computer to guess that certain color based on all of the frames of your project, you click on Guess button. To conclude, when it comes to importing a video from Moho to Adobe After Effects, Straight would be the best choice. If you don't see this window after importing, you just have to select your footage and go to File and choose Import Footage and then Main. And then you can choose the option that you like. Okay, let's say we've imported the files and they're ready. And because I want to create a composition based on the project settings of my Moho project, I use my background layer as a reference. So I right click on it and choose new composition from selection. It's time to drag and drop the layers into our composition. The composition already includes background. Let me play it for you. Note that first time you play something in After Effects, it lags because at the same time it's loading, but the second time it plays it with normal speed. To check that if all of your layers are loaded or not, you can check this green bar at the top of all of the layers. If it's completely green, it means that all of your layers have been loaded. Now I'm gonna drag and drop the rest of the layers into my project. Don't worry about the order of them. If they look wrong to you, you can change the order of them anytime you want. And to find your layers faster, it's very important to rename them. So I'm gonna click on them and hit Enter and type a name for them. If you can't see the name of your layer correctly, you should just click on here. Let me play it for you. Compared to Moho, now you have all of your layers with high quality. While in workspace of Moho, you can't have all of the shadows and effects. Here, we know that these are the final colors of our animation. And this gives us the ability to correct the colors of our project. There are many methods and many effects that you can use to correct the colors of your project. But there is a general way to do that I'm gonna teach you. After learning it, you can use the same way, but with any effect that you like to correct your colors. And not only in color correction, but also you can use this technique in a lot of situations. Like when you want to see if your shape matches each other, or when you want to match sounds. I call this technique mixing and mastering, and I'm gonna explain it for you with an example. Let's say we have separated our project into three layers, and we don't like the colors of any of them, and we want to change them all. On the other hand, let's suppose the colors of layer 1 matches the colors of layer 3. Well, in the first step, called mixing, we should focus on individual layers and try to match them with the other layers. In this case, since layer 1 and layer 3 matches each other, we should focus on layer 2 and try to match it with layer 1 and 3. After that, since we know all of them matches each other and the overall look of the layers doesn't look good, in the second step called mastering, we change the colors of all of them at the same time. And because we're changing them at the same time, they will still match each other, so they can be your favorite colors while matching each other at the same time. To apply any effect to your project, you have to go to effects and presets. Then you should search for your effect here. The effect that I'm gonna use is called hue and saturation. After finding it, you drag it and drop it on the layer that you want. In effect controls window, you can change the settings of your effect. I want to decrease the saturation, so I drag the circle to the left of my slider. And now that the colors of Deadpool layer match the colors of other layers, the mixing step is finished, and now it's time to master. And by mastering, I mean change all of the colors at the same time. To do that, first I have to create an adjustment layer. So what is an adjustment layer? It's a layer that you can apply some effects on it, and then it applies all of those effects on the layers below itself. So since I want to apply all of the effects of my adjustment layer on other layers, I have to move it to the top of all of the layers. It's time to apply the hue and saturation effect on our adjustment layer. Now we are changing the saturation of all of the layers at the same time. You can apply multiple effects on your adjustment layer. For example, I want to add a photo filter effect to it. Using photo filter effect, you can make your colors look warm or look cool, depending on the filter that you choose from here. Let me adjust its saturation and choose a warm filter for our project and play it. See the green line? So we have to wait for it to load. If this is the first time that you're playing it, you have to be patient. And now that it's completed, we can watch our animation with normal speed. And if you like it, you can render it. Here is a quick before and after in case you want to compare them. That's it, guys. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. I choose the best ones for this playlist and I answer them in a video like this. I'll be glad if you like and share, subscribe for more videos, and see you in the next episode. Thank you.